hot cross buns, hot cross buns. One a penny, two a penny, hot cross buns. If you have no daughters, give them to your sons. One a penny, two a penny, hot cross buns.
One a penny, two a penny, hot cross buns. Give them to your sons, give them to your daughters. Everybody's gonna get them. Hello, everyone. Easter is coming. That is why I started our video with the most popular Easter song. And now it's time to plan our Easter lessons. To begin with, I can't but advise you to prepare some eye-catching pictures of Easter symbols and attractive posters to decorate the board and the walls, which will make your kids feel excited at once and create a jolly Easter mood. Easter is a fun cultural holiday lesson, and your kids will be thrilled to hear about British and American Easter symbols, some customs, typical food, and compare with the Russian ones. You can also sing Easter songs and play traditional Easter games. Cross-cultural awareness should be a strong element at your Easter lessons. This time, we'd like to offer you three ways of introducing Easter vocabulary, showing Easter presentation, or colorful flashcards, or Easter toys. Yeah, even better. Chick, egg, happy Easter, basket, Easter bunny, card, jelly beans, lily, duckling, lamb, Easter egg hunt. And now comes Easter vocabulary practice with a wide range of enjoyable games. Apart from our favorite games, tic-tac-toe, domino, bingo, matching games, you can add some new ones for your students. An Easter dice, Easter sudoku, color the eggs in the basket is a kind of colorful dictation. Count the bunnies or eggs, put Easter words in ABC order, whole bunch of activities. For beginners, there are more challenging games, for example, Easter word scrambles or Easter crisscross. Spot the differences between two Easter pictures, various puzzles, word searches, crosswords, and so on. Look in the video description for the link to see those materials. For example, our favorite Easter game is also there. What is there in the grass? That's the name of the game. Look at it for 20 seconds, turn back, and say what you remember. What color are flowers? What color are the chicks? How many little chicks? Or big chicks, or yellow flowers, pink flowers, colored eggs and eggs in the nest, brown bunnies, lambs are there in the grass. By the way, you can find this green grass and other Easter stuff for this game in fixed price shops. No kidding. You can go to any other shop or make them or color everything yourself, your choice. The next one. You can also show your students how British children celebrate Easter. One of the best videos for the youngest kids with easy language is an Easter outing from Longman's We're Kids in Britain. An episode called Easter from This is Britain Level 2 by Oxford University Press is perfect to watch with beginners and then discuss cultural similarities and differences of Easter celebration in the United Kingdom and in Russia. It's a good idea to ask your students to complete the table, maybe in pairs, and it can be like this table, Easter in Britain versus Easter in your country. Or a bit easier, supported by the questions taken from the video activity book, This is Britain 2. What else can be included in our Easter lesson? An Easter song, chant, or even an Easter rap?
Are you gonna battle? I invented him hopping, my little tail swinging and my big ears flopping.
There is a lovely, easy Easter play for the lesson. Why not act out this play then for the parents in May? You can easily choose the appropriate song to sing or wonderful Easter mini books to read from our collection. Egg decorating or an Easter craft activity is fun too. If you are teaching offline, obviously, your best part of the lesson will be, drumroll, Easter movement games. Hey, these traditional games are egg and spoon race, egg rolling, and the best one ever, Easter egg hunt, which should be a must at any Easter lesson. But don't forget to boil your eggs. Don't put raw eggs under the tables and such. As a bonus, you can go through the modal verbs explaining the rules of these games for your students. Well, you mustn't touch the spoon nor the egg with your hand, for example, for the spoon egg race. Regardless of the level of your students, be sure to include a variety of interesting Easter activity. For instance,
To pre-intermediate students, Isher vocabulary can be introduced or revised with these two posters. It seems to be simple, but take them away, the posters, and ask your learners to name all the words they remember. Better to do it in two teams. It could be some sort of competition. Then they can play Isher board games, make new Isher words, change in letters, and also read about Good Friday superstitions or an Isher fictional story, The Princess Isher. Or Steve's Isher trick, listen to Isher rap. Well, you heard that before, or maybe you can find it in the description as well. And finish the lesson on a fun note, playing big Isher bingo with prepositions. Can our intermediate students learn anything new about Isher? Aha, of course they can. Firstly, they can find out why Isher egg, Isher lily, Isher lamb, and Isher basket became Isher symbols, because I have no idea. Then, to enrich your students' vocabulary, offer, in pairs of course, to choose the correct meaning of five egg idioms. For example, what does a bad egg mean? Does it mean a stupid idea? Or a dishonest person? Or bad news? Right you are, it is a dishonest person. Have an egg on your face. Well, what does it mean? Do you look foolish? Do you look bored? Yeah, of course you look foolish, and games like that. What could be completely new is top 10 wackiest Isher traditions around the world. In our Isher collection, you'll find 10 pictures plus 10 short texts and a questionnaire. So let's arrange whole class melee activity to arouse your students' curiosity. Show them two or three photos illustrating the wackiest Isher traditions. Ask them what's happening in the picture and guess the country. Explain the next tasks clearly. They should tell their stories to each other, then listen to as many stories as possible. Then, of course, remember the information in order to complete the questionnaire later. The students get the text, then move around the classroom. They share their stories 9 times. The teacher can give some supporting words on the marker board. Then, working in pairs, they complete the list, answering the questions and matching the answers with the pictures. Really challenging, isn't it? Sounds complicated, but you'll get a hang of it. Don't forget to ask your students to rate these wackiest Isher traditions from 1 to 10, and then compare your students' lists. So, this is it for today. Find the materials in the description to this video. And also, there you'll find a link to join our team of teachers and teach English from any part of the world. This is it for today. Goodbye, ladies and gentlemen.